Hello, friends. Welcome to the Angels and Awakening podcast. I'm your host, Julie Jancis. Friends, I am an angel messenger. I bring through messages from your angels, from your loved ones on the other side. I'm also certified in two forms of energy healing, Chios energy healing and Reiki energy healing. If you'd like to book a 25 or 55 minute angel medium reading with me or Reiki healing session, you can visit my website at www.jancis.com. That's my last name.com. Also, I wanted to let you know that we're going to be doing a question and answer episode coming up soon. So if you have spiritual questions, questions about the other side or angels, hop on over to Facebook or Instagram and follow me at Angel Podcast. That's the @ Angel Podcast. You can PM me over there with your questions or email me and I'll answer those questions on the show. So I'm actually recording this on Tuesday morning and we just got through Labor Day. I hope that you had a wonderful, wonderful Labor Day. And I know that technically it isn't the end of summer, right? But I am just so geared up for everything fall. Bring on that pumpkin spice. Bring on the fall scented candles. The weather with a slight chill in the air where you need cozy long sleeves and layers. Friends, I love all the seasons, but of all the things I just mentioned that bring me tons of joy, fall is the one that I just cherish so much. And we all need to be relishing in the energy of what brings us more joy, right? So I wanted to tell you about something fun that I use. I'm not getting any kickback from this. I'm not sponsored by it or anything like that. I just think it's so fun to have in your house. A few years ago, I got one of those fireplace heaters. As you may recall from past episodes, Blake is not a big fan of real fire in the house, and I completely get it, right? We had a neighbor have a bad fire in their house, and it took them so long to recover from that. But there's something about the fireplace, right? Looking at it all lit up, that just makes me feel so warm and cozy inside, even if it's not a real fire. Now, they sell these electric plug-in-the-wall fireplace heaters that light up in front, and you could put them right in front of the fireplace, or you could actually put them inside the fireplace, and what you do is you turn on the switch in the back, and it lights up, and it looks as if there's a fire burning in there. Well, when I went to go buy these a couple of years ago and I just looked at them on Amazon just to check to tell you what the price was, some of them are over $500, but you don't have to buy them for that expensive price. I got mine at Aldi a few years ago. It was maybe $80 and it's been working for the last 2 to 3 years. I know other people have gotten them more around that price range between $75 to $100, and they work great for years. So this is one of my favorite things that brings me so much joy. I'm really not attached to any of my possessions, but we want to do more of what makes us joyful, right? And this product, it just almost makes me so giddy to walk over, flick on a switch, and voila, there's a fire going in my fireplace. Then I put on my fleece pajamas, I grab my favorite cozy blanket, and I'm ready to read a book or watch a movie, right, by this fire. It's just so, so fun. So I just thought I'd share that with you. I don't get any kickbacks. I'm not sponsored by any of these companies. I just thought that it's a really fun thing to do in the winter if you aren't into having a real fire in your house. So in today's episode, I'm sharing what the energy is like when someone is close to passing. When someone is near their passing, the energy in their auric field shifts. It's palpable. You can feel it. I'm going to share with you what I see happening and the patterns that I see happening throughout my sessions. My other intention for this podcast is to help you have less fear and feel more comfortable working with spirit on the other side, souls who have crossed over, by understanding first what different energies are like, okay? Because there are some energies who, and it's very, very rare, that don't want to cross over. And here on Earth, we have termed those energies ghosts, right? Working with a ghost is very, very different from working with a soul who has crossed over to the other side. And so I get this question a lot, and Spirit has brought this into my life very heavily over the last couple of weeks, where they've put me in situations where I had to work with this a couple of times. And, you know, I only bring through to you the information that Spirit is really working with me on at the time. So I want you to understand that working with souls who have crossed over to the other side isn't scary at all, because they're in heaven. And when you get to work with their energy, it's almost as if you here on Earth are raising your vibration to a point where you're vibrating at a much higher level, and you get to live in this heavenly space as well. Okay. So I know that we always keep it high vibe here. And when you tell ghost stories, it tends to take you to a very low vibrational place, but we're not going to that place today. Okay. We're keeping it fun. We're keeping it completely high vibrational. And if you're new to the podcast, just know that this isn't our typical show. We talk about consciousness, living in a high vibration, connecting with angels, guides, and loved ones on the other side, teaching you how to connect with them. This is not a show about ghosts. It's just something that we happen to be bringing up today so that you feel more comfortable not working with them, but working with souls on the other side. I wanted to say thank you to Marcella for the review this week. Marcella included a little angel story in her review. She said, "Thank you so much. For the past 2 months, I've been listening to your podcast. You are part of my daily routine. Thank you for allowing me to understand my connection with my angels and loved ones. I am more aware of their presence. The other day on my daily walk, I was going through a hard, hopeless day. I was asking for a sign that I was not crazy, that Daniel, my angel, is with me. And I just closed my eyes and I felt an overwhelming wind on me. No scary, just warm. I opened my eyes to see the trees by me. They were not moving at all. No wind at all. It was just for me, letting me know that he was still with me all the time." Marcella, I love that story. Thank you so much for sharing that with our listeners. If you haven't heard yet, I'm picking up to 15 five-star reviews just here from iTunes this month. This is a contest for you to win a free angel message reading with one of the students in the Angel School. I'm also going to be selecting my one pick a month this month from those reviews. But this will also give students in the Angel School who need to practice on people the ability to try and practice on people distance over phone, Skype, or FaceTime. So don't worry if you're not in person in Illinois. That is okay. If you've written a five-star review and posted it on iTunes, Facebook, or Google, I thank you so, so much. And if you haven't, now is the time to rate the podcast 5 stars, write a positive review, and subscribe. Even if you win a reading with one of my students, you'll still be in the drawing to win a reading with me. I keep your name in until you win. Also, don't forget to email me a screenshot of your 5-star review so that I have a way of contacting you when you win. Okay, so jumping into the podcast for today. Now, you may have seen part of this on Facebook where I put up a bit in my stories, but the video cut out. So the entire story isn't over there unless you're in our Facebook group, which is called Angels and Awakening Podcast Tribe. I was able to put the entire video over there. But I have lived in the same town since 2008, and I have been able to avoid going to one restaurant for all of this time until a few weeks ago. A few weeks ago, they were having an event called Boo Hoo, the Kids Are Back in School. They had bottomless mimosas for parents and a buffet all morning long. And my friend asked me if I wanted to go. Of course, I wanted to join my mommy friends, so I went. And why was I avoiding this restaurant for so long? Because there are all of these reports of it being haunted. There's not just one report. There are report after report after report. It is a restaurant that was formerly a funeral home. And I know very well the difference between spirit on the other side in heaven and souls who have refused to cross over to the other side. And I don't work with souls who haven't crossed over. It's not my forte. I have done a little bit of work, which you'll hear about. But for the most part, 99.99% of all of the work that I do is with souls who have crossed over into heaven, the other side. Well, the night before this event, Spirit wakes me up with two things. First, you have to understand what the gift of connecting with the other side is really like. When I'm going to have a session with someone, I can often feel their loved one's energy next to me for hours, sometimes half a day, before I'm right in front of the person that I'm doing the reading for. That's to say that spirit comes in before you do for your session with energy. They are so excited and I can feel their presence for a long time, typically before you get there. Now, I don't mind this energy at all because I ask God to only allow me to connect with spirit who is on the other side, who walks in God's white light. And spirit on the other side, they all have this incredible light, yummy energy. My friends, it is pure love. It is pure bliss, peace. And when you feel this energy, you just want to spend every moment of your day in it because it feels so much like home, right? Home on the other side. The other thing that you have to understand is that I can count on one hand the number of times I've worked with spirit who is still here on earth. These are souls that have not passed over. I don't see working with these souls as my work, right? My purpose. Mainly because most spirit easily crosses over to the other side when they pass. Most souls do not want to stay here on earth. It's actually very rare. And you might ask, what do you mean want to stay here on earth? Does that mean they have a choice? Yes. They have a free will choice to stay here on earth or return home to the other side. I know I'm jumping around here a little bit, but just bear with me. So this brings me to another point that you have to understand, which is what energy is like when a person is close to passing away. What I see is this symbol that they show me when a person has started to transition their energy. And the symbol that they show me is an hourglass. The hourglass isn't a physical hourglass with sand. It's actually the soul's energy. The bottom part of the hourglass is this earth. The top part of the hourglass is the other side. And you've heard people talk about the tunnel that they cross from this lifetime over to the next. They go through a tunnel, right? Well, in an hourglass, you have that small little tunnel between the two sides. And that's what it's like, right? Because when you're here on earth and you're living and you're here, most of your energy is here with you on earth, even though you're omnipresent. Let's call it, spirit just said, your consciousness. The consciousness that you have isn't on the other side. In fact, most of us can't recall at all our previous lives or our previous stay in heaven on the other side, right? So our consciousness is 100% here on earth. But as we start to near our passing, and I've seen it where this process can start 10 years before someone passes, but it typically speeds up a lot and you can feel it more heavily if somebody is within about 2 years of passing. They start to prepare their energy. They start to transition their energy from being mostly here to being on the other side. And when someone is at this end of life point, the energy that I feel throughout working with so many different people is that they either want to go, they're ready, and they're like, I'm good, just take me, right? Or people who are nearing end of life, they put up a big blockage point. They are very strong in that they're not leaving, they're not going. They throw roots down energetically into the earth. And it's almost like a five-year-old child who's having a tantrum, who's saying, I'm not leaving, I'm not going. Now remember, I'm just showing you the patterns that I see while working with so many different people. And what spirit really shows me with this passing process is that it's so much easier for us to get to the end of life and say, I'm ready, just take me. It makes it a completely smooth transition. It's easy, it's gentle. And when people have this energy output of I'm ready, what happens is when their soul leaves the body and they enter into love and peace and joy and the energy of the other side that is just so immaculate, so incredible that you just can't even believe it. People don't want to leave that energy and come back into the body, right? We've even seen with most near-death experiences that I've heard of from my clients, they report when their soul left their body, they immediately entered into an energy unlike any energy they've ever felt before, and they didn't want to leave it. It is home. So for most people, it's very hard to, if you have a near-death experience, to come back into the body. For the other people who are nearing end of life who don't want to go, what I read most of the time or what they show me is that there's some fear in there, some fear of how one or more of their actions from this lifetime is going to be perceived or received when they cross over to the other side. I've seen it before where a person who cheated on a spouse was afraid to pass because they didn't want their spouse on the other side to know. But of course they know if they're already there in heaven. And I've never seen a case where it's not already forgiven by the spouse who's already on the other side. Everything that we've done here gets cleared out in the karmic review process, so there's no reason for us to ever fear crossing over to the other side. One time I worked with a client whose brother-in-law had just passed but didn't want to cross over and was really haunting her house and her to get messages across, right? He had done a lot of damage in this lifetime and he had to get these messages out before he would leave because the messages were just so important to rectifying the bad that he had done in this lifetime. So I was able to work with her and her brother-in-law to get him to a point where he was able to cross over. And he actually came through as he was going through that process of crossing over and thanked me for my assistance. I've also done a little bit of work here and there at people's houses to just clear up low vibrational energies, to work with prayer and sage and special sprays that I mix up to really clear that low vibrational energy out of people's houses. But that's it, right? That is the work that I've done. I'm not a ghost hunter or anything like that, just an angel medium. So when Spirit woke me up in the middle of the night before this event at the restaurant, they told me that I couldn't drink the mimosas at the event because I'd be opening up my crown chakra and exposing it to the energy there, which I hadn't even thought of, but I definitely abided by this. It was funny because when I had that dream of the restaurant the night before going to this event, I also started to feel the energy of the restaurant start to come in. Just like I told you, I start to feel people's loved ones come in before having a session with them. This energy was different though, because it is a soul who is not crossed over. There was so much anxiety. It was like this massive weighted cloud in my auric field, in my heart chakra, in my body. And it's an icky, low vibe energy that just doesn't feel good at all, right? It was extremely heavy and low. And Spirit wants me to remind you all of this, that what I've just spoken about, this is why we don't touch Ouija boards. And I don't even like to say the word, so I will refer to it as an O board. I don't even want to say the name. Never, never, never touch an O board. It holds this low vibrational energy because it is connected to low vibrational spirits who are still here on Earth. It does not connect you to high vibrational spirits who have crossed over on the other side. If you're looking to learn how to connect with your loved ones on the other side, I can teach you that. It's called the Angel School. The O board is actually a portal to low vibrational energy here on Earth, and I believe in staying away from them at all costs. Okay, so fast forward to being at the restaurant. The energy is so heavy there. I'm having tons of anxiety. And my friend was so, so sweet. She said, "Why didn't you just text me? We don't have to stay. Let's go to a different restaurant. Let's just leave." And I just felt like there was a reason why I was there. And I just trusted that. So we started talking with the owner about all of the ghost activity in the restaurant. And he starts talking about how there's just one girl in the restaurant who plays games with him. And I'm like, nope, I'm connecting with at least five spirits. They're talking to me as he's talking to me. And so I just know that it's not one girl. He also starts telling us that this activity is constant. It is all the time. He says that he just went in the other day. He was getting the bar all prepped and there are candies, you know, right when you walk into the restaurant, and from across the room, from the entrance to the bar, this candy just shot across the room and hit him and went into the trash. And he says that the spirits in there, they're not bad. They're not mean. They are actually just kind of funny and they like to play with him. Now he has pictures, he says, of ghosts in the background, of people's faces in the background. And he shared one of those with me. So if you hop on over to my Facebook or Instagram stories, I will put that in there today, just so that you can see one of those pictures that he says he has. Well, of all the places in this restaurant, the most activity comes from the women's bathroom, right? So not only am I not drinking the mimosas, but I'm trying to drink as little water as possible because I'm thinking there is no way that you're getting me to go into this women's bathroom. Of all of my friends, all of their stories come from the women's bathroom. One of my girlfriends went to an event at this restaurant last winter. And when she went to the bathroom, it was one of those locks, like those metal, long, circular locks that you push across to lock your stall. Well, she said there's nobody in the bathroom, right? It's just her. And she's trying to do her business. And all of a sudden, this lock just keeps moving. And it opens. It opens not once, not twice, but three times. And that was one story. I've got another friend who, when she goes in there, she feels people and they're talking to her. She has the gift as well. And she hears multiple spirits in the restaurant and they talk to her whenever she's there. So we didn't stay very long. We actually spent the majority of our time outside in this little patio area outside of the restaurant. And I'm not saying the restaurant's name because it's not a bad place. It's actually got the most delicious food. And I would highly recommend it to anyone who doesn't feel spirit intensely because it is a wonderful, wonderful place owned by wonderful people. But we spent most of the time outside because my anxiety felt better outside versus inside. So before we leave, my friend goes, well, I got to go to the bathroom. And I was really strong about this. I was like, nope, 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 I'm not going up there. And she goes, Julie, look at what you do for a living. You have to experience this. And so I felt this push from spirit that said you can do it. So I did. I went upstairs. The only women's bathrooms is all the way upstairs. And you walk into this bathroom. It's your typical restaurant bathroom, except there is a cardinal on the wall. And this would give me comfort, except it's on a pure black tree with no branches, which is just creepy, right? So we're in the bathroom and there is a female spirit presence in there. And I'm thinking, just don't mess with me. Just don't mess with me. I can't handle this. I do my stuff as fast as possible. And my friend and I are just about to leave the bathroom when literally our hands are on the door that is opening to the restaurant, to leave from the bathroom to the restaurant. And the stall door creeps. I mean, it's just moving on its own. It starts to creep out the opposite direction. And then it goes a little faster and it bumps my arm. And I'm like, go, go, go as fast as you can. I can't handle this. And at that point, I thought, okay, well, if this is what it's like here, right? Where the spirits are just, they're not mean. They're just having fun with people. They're playing with people. I could handle this, right? And going through that experience kind of lessened some of my anxiety. Not completely, but to the point where I just realized that the energy wasn't mean. It wasn't hostile. They were just playing, and the spirits really enjoyed being there because I did have some communication with them. And I asked them at one point, do you want someone to help you go to the other side? And the answer that I got very clearly was no, that they wanted to stay there. So at that point, I felt better about being in the restaurant, still had some anxiety, had this encounter with the energy there, but didn't feel like it was there to harm me, right? Which always makes us feel a little bit better. When I put this story over on Instagram, there was a woman who asked a question, and I've searched for about the last 20 minutes to find that question so I could answer it here, but I can't find it anymore. So if you're listening, I am so sorry. Please send me that question again, and I promise I'll answer it here on the podcast. If anyone else has questions, definitely hop over to Instagram or Facebook. Just search @angelpodcast and you'll find me and you can PM me there. The other thing that I got out of the restaurant experience is, looking back, I wouldn't have all of this info if I hadn't experienced it for myself. But because I did, I'm able to tell you with complete certainty that there isn't anything to be scared of when you're connecting with the other side. That is truly the light, heavenly energy that you want to connect with. And if that's all you get out of today, then going through this experience was so worth it. It's not scary to connect with the other side. Everyone can do it. Everyone can learn how to do it. Not only is it easy, not only does it feel good, it makes you feel so much more connected to your people over there, to your angels, to your higher self. So if you'd like to learn how to do that, if you'd like to learn how to connect with the other side, definitely think about taking the Angel School. And we do have the September, and then in a couple weeks, I am going to put out the dates. We'll have another one in November. We're going to have another school in January and another one in the spring. Friends, remember how Dr. Catherine Perkle was on the podcast a few weeks ago talking about triangulation? She had this poem that she wanted to share, but she couldn't find it at the time. So she sent it to me, and I want to read it to you now because it is just so beautiful. And I can tell you from working with all of my clients, it doesn't matter if your baby is 10 days old or if they are 50 years old. If you are a parent, you can resonate with this poem. It's called On Children by Khalil Gibran. Your children are not your children. They are the sons of daughters of life's longing for itself. They come through you, but not from you. And though they are with you, yet they belong not to you. You may give them your love, but not your thoughts, for they have thoughts of their own. You may house their bodies, but not their souls, for their souls dwell in the house of tomorrow, which you cannot visit, not even in your dreams. You may strive to be like them, but seek not to make them like you. That's a big line. You may strive to be like them, but seek not to make them like you. For life goes not backward, not tarries with yesterday. You are the bows from which your children as living arrows are sent forth. The archer sees the mark upon the path of the infinite, and he bends you with his might, that his arrow may go swift and far. Let your bending in the archer's hand be for the gladness. For even as he loves the arrow that flies, he also loves the bow that is stable. I'm a visual person, so I'll put this up in the stories as well. But I just love that poem because it really talks about how, you know, your children are your children, but you can't make them into what you want them to be because they're their own individuals and they're just going to grow into that. Thought that was beautiful. Friends, I don't ask you to support this podcast with a membership program or with Patreon. If this podcast is something that resonates with you, if it's something that you get value out of, and if booking a session with me is something that resonates with you, that is how I encourage you to support this podcast. You can book a 25 or 55 minute angel reading. You can also book a Reiki healing session. You can do that on my website, www.jansis.com. That's my last name.com. While you're at my website, if you subscribe at the very bottom of my website, you'll be added to my prayer jar. I pray for everybody who has subscribed every morning. And when I have your email address, you'll begin to receive my weekly channeled angel message that I'm going to start this fall. That's a weekly longer angel message that I'm going to be sending out via email to all of my subscribers. So if you'd like to receive that free message, you can hop on over to my website, scroll to the very bottom, and just enter your email address. Also, I wanted to let you know that all of these podcasts are up on YouTube. I'm going to be starting to do more teaching videos over there, more informational videos over there. So if you're on YouTube, head on over and subscribe to my channel. You can find me on YouTube by searching my name, Julie Jancis, or Angels and Awakening Podcast. Friends, thank you so, so much for being here on the show today and listening. I just want you to know how much I appreciate you and all that you do. I hope you had fun listening to this story, and now you know why it's okay, why it's easy, why it feels so great to connect with the other side, and why you feel more lower vibrational energy when you're connecting with a spirit who hasn't crossed over, a soul who hasn't crossed over. So I hope that makes you feel more comfortable. I hope that answers some questions for some people, that it doesn't feel scary to me to connect with the other side. It actually feels so wonderful, so joyous, so yummy, because that is what heaven is. It's a experience. It's a vibration unlike any other vibration that we've ever felt before. And once you feel that energy, you don't want to leave it. You just want to stay in it for forever. My friends, your angels, your guides, your loved ones, they love you so, so much. I asked for messages for you specifically for this week, the week that you personally are listening to this podcast, because everybody listens at different times. And what they said is, let them know that we are sending them signs. They want you personally to know that they are sending you signs, not every week, every day. They send you signs to open your consciousness, to help you understand that you are not alone. They are right there with you, that there is nothing that you can't do in this lifetime, right? You are a piece of the whole. You're a piece of the whole that is God. You are a piece of the whole that is the universe. And if you are a piece of all that is, you are connected with the oneness of all that is. All the answers that you'll ever need in this lifetime, all of the decisions that you're ever going to have to make in this lifetime, you can get to the answers by connecting with that high vibration, by living your life in that meditative state. They also want you to know that from that state of being, from living in that high vibrational meditative state, you can do anything. There is nothing that can't be accomplished here, okay? I know that they have great, great purpose for every single one of us, and that there is room here on earth for all souls, you, me, everyone, to be who they are called to be here on earth. So do your spirit team a favor this week and sit down and just check in with yourself. What are you feeling? Where are you at? What do you need? Where do you feel called to be? What do you feel called to be doing? And when I say that, just look at it as, what is your next action step? Because even though spirit works with everyone, friends, they are able to work and take so much farther those who give 100% to them while they're here. Those who are working for spirit, who are humans here on earth, who say, God, I work for you. What would you have me do? When we do that, they are able to come into our lives, work miracles, make things happen. Friends, I love you so much. They love you so much. Have a beautiful, beautiful week. Open up your heart to all of the unexpected blessings that your angels are bringing into your life right now. Just spend some time with them this week. Until Thursday, I am sending you peace, bliss, and many, many blessings.